Follow a twisting path from the outskirts of the drowning city. Cross a broken bridge and you'll hear it close. The ring of metal and the roar of flame. A craftsman obsessed. Within his forge, the nailsmith is searching, on an endless quest to create a flawless nail. Past failures pile outside his door, exposed to the rains and left to rust. He spares no thought for imperfect things. Nor does he pause to take notice of the countless beings that take their pick of his refuse. But his neglect has impact. His discarded nails have spread wide through Hellenest, clutched tight in the hands of creatures possessed. Only in the night's broken nail does he at last see true potential. Distant and difficult to achieve, but it is in there, waiting. A blade to be honed beyond all others, to be forged into a form so brilliant it transcends its metal and becomes myth. Hello, and welcome to my second video about Hollow Knight lore. This one is all about the Nailsmith. What you just heard was from a Kickstarter update, posted by Team Cherry in late 2014. Nail Santa went through a few changes since then, so this description isn't really canon anymore, but it presents such a great spooky atmosphere, I just wanted to use my new microphone to show it off. So what can I say about this guy? He's definitely a friendly face to see when you first arrive in the City of Tears.
Wait, is that a blacksmith? Oh, it is. Hell yeah, upgrade my weapon, daddy.
Because who doesn't want their nail to do more damage? But looking into the Nailsmith, you find a lot of unanswered mysteries about the guy, and about the nature of nails themselves. While thinking of topics to cover in this video, I started to wonder if the Nailsmith is actually under the effects of the infection. Subtle things here and there make me wonder. In a later Kickstarter update, elaborating on the stretch goal, four more quests, we saw our first glimpse of our friendly blacksmith, though he doesn't look quite so friendly here. When his job is done, when the perfect blade is forged, what meaning remains for the nailsmith? Is there something more the knight can provide? That's all well and good, but look at this image. We see throughout the game that, along with the loss of autonomy, one of the earliest symptoms of the infection are those haunting orange eyes. And I think there can be little doubt that that's what we're seeing here. There's even a little bit of orange goo in the background of the image just to nail it home. More evidence for this theory can be found when comparing the Nailsmith to other infected bugs. Look at the husk sentries outside his forge, still patrolling back and forth. Listen to Quirrell talk about the infected miners in Crystal Peak. Did it sadden you to see those miners below, still laboring at their endless task? Even overcome, strong purpose has been imprinted upon their husks. It seems to fit very well with the talk of the Nailsmith's obsession with creating the perfect nail. Forging more and more imperfect weapons over and over for who knows how long. And sure, the Kickstarter updates are hardly canon, but with all the nails lying around outside the forge, it seems like at least a bit of this stuff made its way into the final product. I also love how there's no way to disprove this theory, since, in the actual game, we never see the nailsmith with his eyes open. If you didn't know, once the knight has upgraded his nail four times, the nailsmith declares that their nail is as strong as it ever could be, the strongest he's ever created, a pure nail. He says he has nothing left to do in life, and demands to be cut down by the knight to feel its exquisite edge. Which is kind of BS when you think about how he charges you 4,000 geo for the upgrade.
Runjo Stenja. Ah. Garadel Akari. Runjo Stenja.
Anyway, if you don't kill him, he goes off wandering through Hellenest and ends up at Paintmaster Shio's place in Greenpath.
Somehow.
This is one of the most wholesome moments in the game. Shio welcomes Nail Santa with open arms, and together they pursue meaning through art. You can find them sculpting figures of the five great knights together, or the nailsmith posing for one of Shio's paintings. It even unlocks the achievement, Happy Couple. The reason I bring this up is because of the effect interacting with other bugs, new friends, or romantic interests can have on bugs in the early stage of infection. Sly gets snapped out of his strange state thanks to the knight coming along, and so does Bretta when saved. Not every infected NPC can be saved this way, of course, but I think this may be what happens with the Nailsmith. His dream nail text, "An age spent toiling alone," this is much nicer, and his general dialogue make it seem like he is doing much better. Could it be that he was pulled from the clutches of the infection by his new friendship with Shio? I think if he was infected when the knight first meets him, he definitely isn't now. Now this is all pretty wishy-washy, and there's not much evidence here. We had enough of that in my Hornet is Void video, so let's take a look at the facts. In their infected state, Sly and Bretta talk to themselves, or people who aren't there, and all other infected NPCs you can talk to, talk complete nonsense. The Nailsmith, on the other hand, is well-spoken, and although he doesn't realize the knight is there at first, he realizes his mistake and greets him right away. I think all the forging and obsession can probably be chalked up to him being a lonely old man with nothing better to do. So I don't think the Nailsmith is infected. But I think it's fair to say that he was originally intended to be. Either way, you never know. Hey, thanks for watching this video. I just wanted to say some stuff about the channel here at the end. So I recorded this audio and edited most of this a very long time ago, and I actually recorded two more theories for this video. But at this point, I think if I'm gonna make those theories into videos, I'll want to rewrite them just because it's been so long and I don't really like some parts of the original versions. Anyway, obviously no one was really into my gameplay video, which is fair enough. You know, I might make a second channel for stupid meme videos like this one, and any other gameplay videos I might make, but I probably won't make any more of those. I've been thinking about making a Let's Play of Silk Song when it comes out, but I don't know if anyone would really want to see that. My flatmate actually started his own YouTube channel, and that made me want to get back into it as well. If anyone wants to check him out, it's a movie review channel called Tui Critic. I'll put a link in the description. Tell him that Cardboard Head sent you, he'll hate it. Anyway, that's enough of my rambling. Look forward to seeing more content on this channel, and I hope all of you have an excellent day.